So good afternoon, everybody. So in my last class, started with the basic concept of utilizations of electrical energy. Okay, with our subject code is 3102. So today I'm giving the details discussions about our syllabus of this subject. Okay, that utilization. Okay, another subject code is E3102. So and that portion that I have already discussed it in my previous class. So normally what is our motivations? Okay, so before starting any of the subjects, we need to know about the motivations of the subjects. Okay, so the basic motivation is that in electrical engineering, rest of our curriculum, we just started with getting the concept about different theoretical aspects, as well as sometimes the laboratory was there. Okay, so here we are going to discuss about different applications of that electrical engineering, and the most of the important prime applications are there. Okay, that's why we are much more focused on these subjects for understanding the what type of applications we are going to be discussed with these subjects. Okay, so the major applications, you know, the traction, heating, welding, then illuminations, these all are the very major applications. And in case of traction, when I'm going to be discussed, so which type of motors are normally used, what are the different tractive force, okay, what are the different characteristics of the traction, and how is it important, why we are going for that tractive effort. Okay, if the traction is there in the plain land, okay, so if that is in inclined land, okay, if there is inclined, so what will be the differences with our normal concept. Okay, so different applications will be there. Okay, so that is our basic motivation. So before starting any of the subjects, we need to know about 3WH words. So what, why, and how. Okay, so what is electrical utilization? That I have been already discussed. Okay, so it's related. In my last class, I have also discussed about the motivations of the subjects. Okay, like you know that I taken some example of the drives. Okay, so what happened in traction? Indian Railway was established by the British government. So that's why the prime mover. Okay, the prime mover, time to time the prime mover has changed. Okay, you know that prime mover means that prime concept that is related, that is responsible for the rotations of your traction motor. Okay, so that is your prime mover. So initially when that Indian Railway was established, that time which type of you know that steam engine. Okay, that time the steam engine was installed to for the tractive purpose. Okay, directly that motor was not there. Okay, you know that the stroke engine, so two stroke engine, four stroke engine. Okay, so that movement of the shaft. Okay, so there is a chamber. Okay, with the heating of that gases. Okay, heating of the gases, the compressions. Okay, that chamber air pressure has changed. Okay, so the movement, the due to the changes of the volume of that gas inside of the chamber. Okay, so then what happened? The piston was there. Okay, so then as the pressure and the piston, so piston was moving. Okay, there is a linear movement of the piston. Okay, so linear movement of the piston, that is responsible for movement of the stroke engine. That was the concept. Okay, so you know about that IC engines. Okay, that you have already gone through in your mechanics, I think so, mechanics in your first year. Okay, so the concept of the stroke engine. Okay, so an IC engine. Okay, so different concept was there. Okay, so first directly they are not using that motor. Okay, motor concept is coming quite later. Okay, so directly that stroke engine concept was there. Initially it was in steam, driven by the steam turbine. After that, it was driven by that diesel. Okay, so steam engine, then diesel engine, then it has come that electric electric supply was there, means electrical. Right now, all that locomotives, most of the cases, means most of the places in India, that driven by that electric supply. Okay, so electrical locomotives are there. So if it is hilly area, then what happened? That locomotive, there is an incline, na? So incline means directly WH. That WH is known as that weight. Weight is directly coming, taking by that earth, means that engine weight. Okay, so that has changed. Okay, so with the cost factor was there. So direct force also been changed. So that what will be the equations of that conditions? Okay, that also been discussed in these subjects. Okay, so in case of the next generation has come. So then we are using that mechanical. You know that prime mover is moving by the chemical energy, then mechanical energy, and finally it is in electrical energy. Okay, in your right now that induction motors are using in the traction, but initial races, okay, means 10 years back also you can get some DC series motor was there. Okay, for our normal, in case of Indian scenario, the again that EMU is there, means there is EMU, then MEMU, different technical term you heard about it. Okay, so as per their name, so sometimes the conception of their control also been changed. Okay, so that which type of engine you are using. Okay, so initially that only induction motor is using for Rajdhani. Okay, so and the rest of the EMU and MEMU they are using for DC series machine. Okay, right now the current scenario that all the DC setup, all the DC machine has changed, replaced by the induction motor, and there is a vector control was there. Okay, means drives right now is very much sophisticated. Okay, sophisticated means drives means there will be the sensor. Okay, sensing of the speed. Okay, sensing of the speed means directly, you know, the sensor and transducer, that chapter. So again, it will be converted. The speed will be converted to the voltage. Okay, by the TACO generator. Then you have given some of the reference voltage. Okay, then there is a calculations of the error. Okay, after getting the error, you are fed to the system, to the control portions. Okay, error will be there, means then the controller will be there. Okay, which type of controller you are using, that also been important. Then after doing the control, so some control logic will be developed. That control logic will be controlling some of the switches, means power electronic switches. Okay, the power electronic switches is there, means then power electronic switches are there, means definitely then there is a control of some of the topology of the converter, maybe inverter, you can say like that. In cases you can you know that inverter, or maybe sometimes cyclo converters. Okay, that drives. Okay, then from this converter topology, you can change the voltage level as well as the frequency level. Basically, it's an AC drives. So you know that VYF control, okay, VVF control means variable voltage, variable frequency control, sometimes VYF control. What is the difference between VYF control and VVF control? Normally, in VYF control, you should maintain the flux fixed. Okay, so why you are making that flux line fixed? You know that hysteresis loop. Okay, if flux is saturated, okay, you are increasing the voltage and you are increasing the frequency, as the frequency is a function of voltage. Okay, you know that frequency in EMF, that transformer equation is there, no? So generation induced EMF expression. So at that case, you know that induced EMF is a function of frequency. Okay, that frequency is changing means automatically voltage will be changing, but how much that voltage will be changed? Okay, you know that BH loop concept, that hysteresis loop. So after, when that current strength is more, okay, so at the level of that current strength, okay, maximum level of the current strength, then you can say like that flux will be, means molecular magnets will be, all the molecular magnets will be aligned in the ferromagnetic core. Okay, if all the magnetic field, all the molecular magnet is aligned, so still you are giving more current, means you are increasing the current intensity, but the flux density will not be increased so much. So you can say like that saturations. Okay, you can say like that, saturations type of nonlinearity. Okay, that nonlinearity also relevant to your advanced control system, na? In control system 2. So there is a chapter of nonlinear control. So all the subjects, if you think like that, from the basic electrical, then analog electronics, power electronics, machine, then again that nonlinear control. Okay, so all the subjects are in line of that concept. Okay, that's why I am telling about that subject is totally related to the applications of that electrical engineering. And most important applications in Indian scenario, that is tractions, illuminations, heating and annealing. Okay, these three are the prime applications. Okay, you know that in our nearer to the campus, that RSP. Okay, I am not going with you RSP, so your senior batch. Okay, so I just visited with them to the RSP plan, means RSP workshop. Okay, last year before that COVID situations. Okay, so if you know that there is a different ovens are there, na? So coke oven, then different then soft iron, sponge iron. So I don't know that they are not they are making that soft iron plant or not. So some specifications are there definitely. So that oven, which type of oven is it? It is electrical ovens. Okay, that ovens not like only in your RSP plant, that type of, sometimes that type of ovens is also available in different railway workshops. Okay, those workshops, if you know that some of the workshops are very old. In my native place, means in my town, nearer to the town, okay, one railway workshop is there, that is called Kachapara Railway Workshop, that is 150 years old. When I was in BTEC, means UG courses, I was in third year. Okay, that is, right now we are in third year. So after my completion of sixth semester, I visited there. I just see that they are preparing the wheel. Okay, so that normally that railway wheel is not directly, they are not preparing, they are taking it from that different all the materials like your railway tracks, okay, railway wheel, everything is designed for Indian railway. That sail is designed, everything for that Indian railways. Normally it is coming from the Bhilai plant. Okay, I just see there, but sometimes what happens, small thing, if you see the guard ring, okay, girder of that railway track, okay, that was designed in that, that was designed in my UG, that time I was in undergraduate in 2008. Okay, so 2008-09 session actually. So that time 2009 I think so. So I was there, I just see that they are preparing that that garden. Okay, so means in rail, if you visit the railway workshop, any of the workshop, you can see they are designing everything. Okay, so they are only procuring the core, means some only procuring some of the material, but they have designed everything in the, in case of machine designing. Okay, they are from lamination to core making, everything they are doing. Okay, so which type of specification, why they are doing, there is also some motivations. Okay, means in case of in that sophisticated, in that case specific applications, na? In different country, different application, different specifications. Okay, if you try to purchase that locomotive machine in Indian market or foreign market, you will not get over there. Why? Basically, as per their rating specifications, you know that normally what happened in our traction line, okay, that overhead, what is the rating of that overhead? There is a two type of conductor, one is called catenary, one is called contact wire. Okay, contact wire means your pantograph is touching to the contact wire. Okay, so there is a difference if you see the cross-sectional area of that contact wire and the catenary, these two will be different. Okay, the cross-sectional area of that contact wire, it is look like a 8. Okay, and the cross-sectional area of that catenary means the whole tension. Okay, that will coming in my some slide. Okay, that whole tension will be given to the catenary to hanging that contact wire. That contact wire is touching with your pantograph. Okay, so pantograph giving you a lot of pressure. Okay, to the lot of pressure to the catenary. It's look like a Z shape, na? So it's having springs are there. So normally, yeah, normally what happened? There is no wire in your in the means locomotive, in the above the locomotive. So the paint row will be removed. Okay, so there is some pressure. Okay, there is some force to make it within that limit. Okay, basically what happened? If there is no pressure, if there is a gap between pantograph and that contact wire means catenary, then what happened? Contact wire. If there is a air gap, so continuous flashing will be there. Okay, basically it's a huge voltage, that is 25 kV, and your relay potential means your coach potential is zero. So if there is a difference between 25 kV and zero, so all the time there will be the flashing. That's why they should touch. Okay, they should touch all the time. Okay, still that's why some spring is there. Sometimes it is moving. Okay, bouncing. Okay, so all the time it is maintaining that continuous contact in between the pantograph and that contact wire. Okay, so it is 25 kilowatt. Okay, sorry, 25 kV means 25 voltage, kilovoltage. So it's a odd specifications. Okay, why that kinds of odd specifications? That also coming. Basically, that normally if that odd specification is not there, so anybody can steal that electricity. Okay, so in India everything is possible. Okay, so hook. Okay, so somebody, it is coming from that nearer to the village. Okay, suddenly they can hook that one. So for the only 25 kV. Auto transformer is designed by the railways. Okay, not from the other industries. Okay, they don't have give any permission. That government don't give permission to design such kinds of specifications in different industry. Like your you know that you are using in your home, you are using that gas, na, that Indian or HP different gas cylinder you are using. The regulator of that gas cylinder. Okay, that also means that is a patent. Okay, so that's a regulator only designed by that specific company. Okay, and that company can only give to that specific PSUs, like your Indian, like your HP. They cannot able to give it in Amazon. I don't know that currently it is available in Amazon or not. I don't have any idea because I have not given a search to the Amazon for gas regulator. But normally, in a normal common shop, you are not able to get it. Okay, why? Basically, there is some restriction. It is specially designed. Otherwise, what happened if they are giving the permission to design by the each and every company? Then there is a black marketing of your. Gas cylinder, na? So that's the concept. So we have to design everything that should be the relevant. Okay, the relevancy should be there. Okay, so if the relevancy is not there, then there should not be any motivation. So I am giving a lot of examples. Okay, so now you are in almost, you are in pre-final year, means you have almost completed your graduations. Okay, so final year totally you should focus about the placement. Okay, and the basic concept you have already taken from that curriculum, the basics of your basic electrical, basic electronics, then machines, all the basic power system, control system, all the basics right now with you. Now you have to brush up yourself to reach that level, basically the competitions, na? So then when you are going for the applications, so you cannot say like that I am only from electrical engineering background. Okay, when you will join to the industry, so you have to know the idea, the basic idea for the all subjects. That's why in first year you should learn about that civil engineering, that means mechanics is the basic subjects of the very basic subjects of civil engineering and mechanical engineering. So that is also important for your when you are designing for a smart home. Okay, smart home electricity. Now the concept of illuminations. Okay, so there is also generation changes for the illuminations. Okay, initially you know that we are using some mercury lamp. Okay, in different puja pandal, if you see, not like puja pandal, any of the occasions we are using mercury lamp. It's a very heat it was generated. If you attend in last, if you are able to, I don't know, your age is right now maybe in the range of 20, okay. So if you go back 20 years back, okay, if you go to the 20 years back, at that time, if you attend any marriage ceremony, so you can see there is a video camera, okay, there was some presence of video camera, and some person was there, they are highlighting or they are illuminating some light, so they are holding some of the lamp in their hand, that was mercury lamp, and that providing lot of heat, okay, and the reflectors are there for focusing to the bride and groom, so they can catch the, they can, as they can, they are brightening, actually they are brightening the means that surroundings, like, okay, so for catching the better videos, like that way. So at that time they are using such type of lamps, okay, mercury paper lamp, okay, different lamps was there. Right now, in my last few days back, in last month, there is a marriage ceremony of my younger brother, so I just see, not like there, so in my own marriage ceremony also, so I just see that that concept is totally changed, okay, so they are not using such type of lamps, okay, so now they have designed that type of lamp by using some LED chain, okay, or that concept of the reflectors are now, it is generation has changed, it means the reflector generation also been changed, okay, so which type of reflector you need to be used, which type of lamp you have to be designed, that also been studied in your illuminations, okay, so that's the basic concept, okay, so before starting any of the subjects we need to know why it is important. So in current scenario we need to clear about the basic motivations, so unnecessary we should not do anything, okay, if anybody asks you to please follow this rule, so first question is that why we are following that rule. So we need to know the benefits, we need to, all the time it is, if there is benefits, it's not like that, all the time there may be some pros, some cons are there, means advantage as well as some disadvantage, all the methods having some advantage, some disadvantage, that we are right now we are giving the virtual classes, it having some advantages as well as some disadvantages, okay, but we have to think in our own brain that how much advantage you are getting and how much disadvantage you are getting, now you have to balancing them. Like your differential amplifier, okay, so you are getting the error may be positive as well as negative, so positive error means you have to mitigate that positive error and make it to the nearer to the zero, okay, the concept of that under damping system in the control system, okay, so that's all the time you have to think such a manner, so if anybody telling you something, so you have to think about their voice, so is he telling you, is he, if he or she is telling you the right one or wrong one, you have to think about it first, okay, so don't believe blindly any of the person, if I am telling you something, definitely you have to cross check it, okay, is this, sometimes what happen if the sir all, it is not right that all the time sir is telling you the right one, okay, it's not right, okay, I am telling you means boldly, you have to cross check, you have the right to cross check each and every points, okay, so that gives you the confidence, okay, that gives you the confidence, so before starting any of the subjects we need to know about the motivations of the subjects and why it is important and how it is important, okay, that's why I am giving this slide, what, why and how, so I think all of you able to understand what is the motivation of this chapter, then you know that why it is important, okay, and finally how it is important, that is coming in your next slide, okay, so one by one that modules are there and you have to cover that individual modules, okay, the means, how means you have to know the all the modules in very well manner, okay, that's the basic concept, okay, I think I am properly audible from your side and all of you getting my ideas, okay, if you faced any kinds of difficulties after completion of my session you can ask me, so I am able to give your answer, okay, if any kinds of confusion has arrived, okay, so now you see that the syllabus of my slides, okay, so that the syllabus is consist of the syllabus is consist of 5 modules, okay, that module 1, to module 5. So module 1 is totally discussed about the electric traction. Okay, so I have already discussed about, you know about that, what is electric traction. So okay, so electric traction means it having consist of some sub portion, sub modules are there. Okay, so that is covered that railway electrifications. Okay, means in the railway what type of electrifications are needed, is it three phase, is it single phase, it is two phase. Okay, what type of electrifications are there, what type of ratings are available, what are the different types of substation involved that of electrification, what type of conductors are there. I am telling about you the conductors. One is catenary, that is another one is contactor. Catenary provide you the mechanical strength. Okay, so what will be the nature of that conductor? It will be the ACSR conductor. Okay, aluminium conductor, steel reinforced. Okay, so it is ACSR conductors. Okay, that is your catenary conductor. Okay, then there is some dropper and you are holding that contact wire. Okay, contact wire, it is not a ACSR conductor, it's a cross sectional area, is a look like a 8. Okay, you can see any of the standard book. Okay, so normally it is designed with the amalgam, with the alloy of your cadmium and copper. Okay, so why cadmium and copper? Basically the current means current density as well as the flowing rate of the current is high in the copper. Okay, so losses will be less in the copper. Okay, why cadmium? Cadmium provide you that mechanical strength. Okay, mechanical strength, sometimes it's a huge tensions is there. Okay, so that will be provided by the cadmium. Okay, and that corrosion. Okay, so corrosive, basically what happened, it is touching na, so pinto always touching with your contact wire, so there is an effect of corrosion. So that's why cadmium also provide you that amount of strength. Okay, it's not so easy corrosive material. Okay, so that railway electrification, then definition and analysis of traction effort. Okay, so what type of traction efforts are available? Okay, the standard methods we are normally maintained. Then speed time curves. Okay, so speed time curves, what are the interaction, normally mainline traction, suburban and urban. Okay, three types of traction methods are there. As per their changing of their method, the speed time characteristics also been changed. Okay, then the traction motors, battery driven vehicles. Okay, you know that points very that EVs. Okay, so if possible some of the portions I can add over there in our syllabus, so you can see different portions, not directly related to your syllabus, but some of the for your information. Basically we have to design the subjects from your information as well as the subject study. Okay, both should be there. Okay, so battery driven vehicles, right now lot of work on going on it. Okay, battery driven vehicle means it's not like only EV means electric vehicles, it having lot of category, two wheeler for the city rides, three wheeler for the public transportations and that goods carrier. Okay, as well as the four wheeler means now it is in a totally sophisticated public transport, and finally that electric bus. Then electric bus also been in the picture. Okay, in our country, government of India also promoting that concept. Okay, and final one is electric train, battery driven trains also we working on. You know that you heard about that bullet train. Okay, you heard about, it's not the battery driven train. Okay, that is called that what is the name, that magnetic levitations. Okay, magnetic levitation, then rest of the things. Okay, so it's also coming from sometimes battery driven trains. Okay, so it's important. Then energy efficiency drives. Okay, energy efficiency drives. So which drives are more sophisticated? Intellectual means power module based drives. Okay, so which drives is important right now? Initially when the power electronics converters are not so developed, okay, that time they are using Arno converters. Okay, Arno converters are normally used for single phase to three phase. Okay, single phase to three phase conversions. Okay, that is used for your loco drives. Okay, locomotive drives. Okay, means three phase engine means that time the Rajdhani engine only designed by that time the Rajdhani engine was coming from Switzerland. Okay, so specially only one Indian, only one railway workshop it was only designed, that was in Chittoranjan. Okay, right now all the there is no all the products are indigenous. Okay, normally that all the machineries will be developed by the VEL. Okay, and VEL also supplying that machineries to the railways. Okay, so all of the very reputed PSU. Okay, so all the PSU are involved each other and they are giving much more trust on the indigenous concept. And that time, very initial days is, okay, not like very old concept, it is 10 to 15 years back I am telling about you. So 15 years back, that time power electronics converters are not so popular. Right now it is very popular. So all the power electronics drives, means cycloconverter drives, battery driven drives, cycloconverter drives, inverter drives, everything is available very easily. Lot of companies are there. Okay, but that time it was not so popular. So they are normally believe on different machines. Okay, that Arno converter also one concept of is one type of machines. Okay, that is responsible for single phase to three phase conversion. Okay, so that three phase will be fed to the induction drives. Okay, sorry, that induction motor. Okay, then to the locomotive. Okay, what type of locomotive? Rajdhani locomotive. Basically at that time only induction motor is using for that Rajdhani express. Okay, right now all are going for that defined locomotive. So sorry, for AC drives, means induction motor drives. And you know that one is important thing is your that is called breaker, circuit breaker. Okay, circuit breaker, another circuit breaker and the isolator. Okay, these two, you know that two terms is very much popular term in for the power system background. Okay, but that also been used in your locomotive. Okay, so for isolating your inputs. Okay, the isolating your input coming from your overhead connection to your system. Okay, so normally you are using the circuit breaker. What type of circuit breakers you are using? So as per the rating of the system, the circuit breaker also been changed. Okay, we are not using that oil rate circuit breaker. We are not using normally in traction drives where it is air breaker circuit breaker is used, as well as some vacuum circuit breaker. Okay, these two circuit breakers are used. Oil, normally they are doing everything for oil free. Okay, so oil free means again there is a dusty area, means it's a problem, na? So that's why they are avoiding that oil MOCB, BOCB, defined okay, circuit breakers are there. You know that those who are doing the VT. Okay, so then energy efficient drives, advanced speed control measures. Okay, then tractive effort calculations, electric braking. Okay, so braking means again the electric drives concept. What type of braking? Regenerative braking or plugging? Okay, or which type of braking you are using? Or dynamic braking? Okay, so which type of braking you are going to be used? I think that portion is covered in your electric drive syllabus chapter. Okay, then control wire means controller, which type of control you are using. Then AC tractions, recent trend in electric tractions. Okay, that are the most important thrust areas for the module 1. Okay, means electric traction. Next module, we are going to give the emphasis on electric furnaces and the welding. Means in a single word you can say like that, heating and welding. Okay, what type of heating we are using, what are the different methods of heating. Okay, what type of welding we are using, what are the different methods for welding. Okay, that also been discussed in this chapter. Okay, so you know that different examples are there: resistance heating, induction heating, arc furnaces. Those who are doing their vocational training in plant, which type of plant? Okay, traction related to means your workshop. Okay, any of the workshop means railway workshop. Then heating welding, if you want to see that plant, means you have to go to the you can attend to the sale, means RSP you can visit, basically metallurgical plant, okay, metallurgy, as well as you can also attend in Tata Steel, okay, that also been very good company. So different companies are there. Their concept, more or less concept is same. So if you want to see the furnace, you can see over there. Okay, so power plant, I think power plant, it's an application, but their application is quite different. Okay, so it is not directly coming under that electrical utilizations. Okay, power plant also be very important. Okay, so power plant and the substations, normally you know that three type of substations are there. Okay, so transmission, distribution, another one is generation, transmission and distributions. Okay, so generating substations is there in the power plant. Okay, so if you are able to visit any power plant for a 15 days 20 days vocational training, so you can see that substations, what type of transformers are using over there. Okay, that is more important thing. Okay, the connections of the transformer in distribution section, the connection was of the distribution transformer is different. It is normally YD11 is there. Okay, but in DY11, but in case of generating substation, the generation is normally done in your star terminal. Okay, so in that case the transformer configuration is different. Okay, so as well as in your transmission section, again you need to know about the transformer. So is it power transformer or the distribution transformer? If the power transformer is there, so in distribution transformer, the power transformer also be there. Means in exactly distribution substation, normally what happen, if you see, there are different ranging is there. Means 132 by 33 kV substation is there, that is called distribution substation. Okay, still it having some in your nearer place of your home, if you can see some pole mounted substations. Okay, means pole mounted transformer, that is also the substations. Okay, it having some rating, the rating of the substation is 11 by 400. Okay, you know such type of configuration in the in our campus also. Okay, that is also the distribution transformer, but this is distribution transformer, but distribution substation having distribution transformer as well as some power transformer. That 132 by 33 kV transformer, it's an example of a power transformer. So there is a difference between tap changers in distribution substation distribution transformer and the power transformer. There is a huge difference are there. So in case of traction, they are also using different type of transformer, like your auto transformer, but that auto transformer having three windings. Okay, one winding is for your power means main traction drives, another two winding is used for your auxiliary winding. Okay, one is your power winding, another two is your first side, like auxiliary winding, that is one auxiliary winding is for that internal electricity, another auxiliary winding is using for the different relays. Okay, protective devices are there in your means. In case of relay, again it is LT relay, ST relay, low tension relay, high tension relays. Okay, so which are relevant to the low tension, again the voltage level. Okay, so in that case, some of the very important relays, some of the all the relays are important, but still there is some primary relay, secondary relay, like that way. Okay, so lot of concepts are there. Okay, so how much I can able to cover, so I am trying my best. Okay, but you know that everything is not possible to cover. Okay, so that's why, because I am from the academics person. Okay, so in the industry I can give you some of the ideas. Basically I did lot of VTs in my UG career. Okay, so more or less lot of VTs in different vocational training in distribution substation, transmission substation, generating substation. Okay, then different two power plant, one I came to here, that RSP, NSPCL power plant. Okay, when I was in UG, that UG level, I just coming here for industrial visit in your NSPCL power plant, means NTPCCL power plant, means in our RSP. Another thing, I did it for another power plant in my nearer to my native place. Okay, then railway substations. Okay, and these kinds of thing I did the VT, but I am not able to get the scope to VT for any power, means steel plant. Okay, that is also very good VT. You can get the idea for different, get the idea means you get some scope to visit some of the workshops. If you able to, last year we went to the VT, we went for the VT in RSP. So where we just visited the LT machine LT machine as well as HT machine means workshop. Okay, both are in the same section, but there is some subdivisions. Okay, so that compound drives was there, means the lift. Okay, that pulling of the your machines, everything, that compound drive was there. Okay, that all the students, means 45 students was there with me, so they are also enjoying the entire the visit. So that type of educational tour is very, very important for UG career. Right now you have that all those concept, that means theoretical concept from your book. Now you need to get some practical exposure, means real time exposures, means you have to attend, you have to visit some of the industry to get that real time exposure. Otherwise what happened, your knowledge will not be in so much concrete. Okay, so that confidence will not coming up to the level. Okay, that's why you have to visit the real time applications. Okay, so that's why you need to attend some of the industry when the situation will be good. Okay, that time you have to try to attend if you have the scope. Okay, some of your parents are working in different plants. Okay, like different plants means different steel plants, power plants. Okay, also sometimes railway workshops, they can go there and try to understand how it is working on it. So if you have that type of scope, okay, try to avail it for your own benefits, not for my benefits. Okay, I did it from my UG career, so I no need to get such type of idea. I have some of the idea on it, so that is your benefit. That's why the subject is important, and the relevancy of the subjects and the realizations of the subjects is important. Then in module 2, that means melting that carbon, and that I am telling you that welding equipments, characteristics of carbon and melting, arc welding, bar welding, spot welding. So that will be discussed thoroughly in my classes. Okay, so time is going near, time is almost over. Okay, so I need to complete this early. So in module 3, we are going to be discussed about electrochemical process. Okay, that process is important for electrolysis, electroplating, electrodeposition. So okay, extraction of the metal. So nearer, you know, like that material, that means material science, metallurgy science. Okay, so relevant to that track or related to that courses. Okay, and module 4, another most important module, that is illuminations. Okay, production of the lights, lighting calculations, determination of the MACP, means you need to know where that exposure is there. Okay, so what will be the points. Okay, MACP, the polar curves of different type of sources. Okay, so residues constructions, photometers, interior and exterior illumination system, lighting schemes, design of lighting schemes, factory lighting, floor flood lighting. Okay, means stadium lighting also be there. Okay, stadium lighting, floor lighting, electric lamps, gaseous discharge lamps, means different types of lamps. Okay, that also been discussed in my class. High pressure and low pressure lamps. Okay, means neon sign, high frequency and low pressure discharge tube. Okay, that all are very important. Okay, those who are instrumentations. Okay, some of the times you can visit, if possible, some of your sometimes what happen, like BSNLs. Okay, right now BSNLs, that plant, there is no such direct plant. Okay, their office inherently, it's a big means it having lot of instrumentations. Okay, so in BSNL, so some of you feel able to try, so you can also visit there to know about some of the instrumentation portion. Okay, how they are working on it, and means how the different instruments are there and they are working on it. So it's a very good options also. Okay, then last one is your refrigeration and the air conditioning. Okay, so control of temperature means temperature control method, basic of wiring diagram, some simple heat, load and motor calculations. Okay, air conditioning, functions of the complete air conditioning system, type of compression motor, fan motor, wiring diagram for the typical air conditioning unit. So that is standard syllabus, okay, that I need to be followed. Okay, so I'm try to maintain that in line of the syllabus, but some of the differences will be there. Okay, so how much I can able to complete by the given time period. So I am trying to my best to complete everything. So these is some books names are there for essential reading and supplementary reading. You need to follow that books. Okay, so you can you can download some soft copy of the book if possible. If I get some soft copy of the book, so I will also share it to the MS team. So for your help, if it is possible. Okay, otherwise you can also download any of the resources, no problem. Okay, so which book we are going to be followed by the ACT party, that electric energy utilization and the conversion, it is TMH book. Then Stocker and the Jones for the refrigeration air conditions. Okay, that is specially for that air conditioning. Then CL Wada book is also very good. So some generation distribution utilization of the electrical energy, that you can also follow. New Age publication, CL Wada book, and Fusion Arena books is there. Okay, that is totally depends upon your utilization of the electric power. Okay, that is only. Okay, so you can follow these books for your for gathering your knowledge and the numerical problem. So sometimes I am also following some different numerical problem to my slides also. You should follow that slide to know that numerical problems. Okay, so that is enough for today. So I am try to complete my introductory section. Okay, introductory portions. Okay, so I think all of you can follow my ideas, all of you can understand that I am telling, I am trying to tell you. So if you have faced any difficulties, definitely you can ask me, so I can repeat some of the portions. Okay, so thank you again. So I am going to take your